Alrighty, time for round one. I would in fact like to play first. Yeah, this hand is great. We're going to be making some whirlers this game. Actually, maybe not. Just going to curve out with Aether Swooper into Pricata Pillar Bug into Daring Demolition. But hey, you got a Whirler Maker just in case, you know. Another Swooper. Probably still going Pillar Bug on three. We'll see what my opponent does. Skyship Plunderer. So, certainly going to attack here. Question in, make a servo. The question is, now that I've drawn Augmenting Automaton, I'm actually a little bit more inclined to play another Swooper and just play the Automaton. Because then I get to block the Plunder, stop my opponent from triggering its ability, and get more things on the board. Mobile Garrison? All right, well, this can become a 3-4 on the ground here, but I can just attack in the air. I think I'm just going to attack with the one Swooper since I can only make one thing. I guess I could have played Poisoner and made another one, but I'd rather just do this and then play a Pillar Bug. Next turn, I can Daring Demolition perhaps. Puzzle Knot. There goes my Augmenting Automaton. Zzt. That's fair. And a Narnam Cobra. All right. Could use a big improvised creature. That would be a nice draw here. Though the way this game is going, yeah, that Whirler Maker might be making some whirls. Really? Okay. Untap a Cobra. Yeah, I'm actually fine trading a Pillar Bug or two servos for this thing, especially since with a Fire Forger's Puzzle Knot out, this block does not work very well later. Okay. Glassblower's Puzzle Knot. Well, better than the land, I think. Let's go either Poisoner and attack with the Swooper and make a servo. And pass. Oh, they traded. Though I guess one disadvantage, maybe I should have played the Puzzle Knot actually. One disadvantage to playing the Poisoner is that it gets picked off by Fireforger's Puzzle Knot, but that does waste three of my opponent's mana. Blue Implement. Okay, draw two cards. Oh, is this a 5-drop? Oh, Maverick Thopterist. That's unfortunate. Well, Bastion Adventure's nice. If I play a Puzzle Knot, I could actually trade a Swooper for a Thopter and then play this, but I think I'm just going to play this. And pass the turn. I could trade Aether Poisoner for a Thopter. I guess maybe that's better than trading it for a Puzzle Knot. I don't know. But we are getting towards the kind of game where Whirler Maker is good, I suspect. All right, let's see what's next here. This is another big improvised creature. No, Chandra's Revolution killing my Swooper? Sure. Alright, well, let's send in the Bastion Inventor and the Poisoner. And I'm playing Whirler Maker this turn, so I'm not particularly worried about playing a Puzzle Knot first. Alright, trade Inventor for those two, and then that means I can start attacking on the ground here with my servos. Prophetic Prism. Okay, so I'm playing it certainly like a pretty heavy improvised deck here. And yeah, there's a lot of improvised cards. All right. Well, Watchful Automaton's kind of annoying because that does mean my servos can no longer attack. But all right, let's see. I think I'll be Whirler Making here. I'm going to attack with the Poisoner, though. And pass the turn. I'll just be making a Thopter every turn for a few turns, and if I draw lands, so this is upkeep. Yeah, sacking map, getting mountain, so they're not splashing, even with that prism. This person didn't take the Whirler Virtuous? Oh, no, this is Draft Leagues. Never mind. Never mind me. And I'm happy trading here, because I think long game Whirler Maker is better than Watchful Automaton in terms of the value you're getting. Oh, I'm getting Puzzle Knotted, sure. Take some damage. I actually wouldn't mind drawing lands here. Let's see. Scrapper Champion. That I might want to Daring Demolition at some point. I can chump with a servo for now. I'll wait. Another thing I would really like to draw is just like another big improvised creature, because I can probably set up a situation where I get to make the improvised creature and use Whirler Maker on the same turn. So let's see. They're going to pay energy, I assume. clock chump. Go to 13. So if I draw land and I can play a 2-drop. Uh-oh. What is this? Just does this release the gremlins? Oh, barricade breaker. All right. Well, that I can block with Aether Poisoner, so that's actually not that bad for me. I think I'm just going to play a... I actually have one card in hand. I'm going to Implement Malice them, take their last card. And then I can play Prophetic Prism. This helps me hit land drops here. Ooh, a Swooper? Oh, I'll play the Swooper. Welding Sparks? Yeah. That's a good last card to hit. All right. This looks pretty good. I mean, my opponent does have Watchful Automaton. This is the kind of game where Watchful Automaton does something. But, like, they're going to scry upkeep here, for example. But I still think I'm in okay shape here. All right, my opponent put a card on top. I had to go open the chat to find out. Oh, they're attacking with the Watchful Automaton. Huh. That's interesting. What does that do? Okay. Well, interesting, interesting. What does that mean? So, Aether Poisoner is going on Barricade Breaker. That's a certainty. The question is, do I double block Watchful Automaton with Servos and take six off Scryper Champion, keeping the Aether Swooper alive, or do I block with Swooper? No, I think I'd rather just double block here and leave Swooper alive, and I'll take six damage. I have no fear of burn spells. All right. And my opponent put a card on top, so it could be something great. Annoying. Oh, they're just using Watchful Automaton again? Okay, well, I do like that. And they're putting a card on the bottom. And I take six here, but killing the Watchful Automaton, I think, is pretty important. Really don't want that card. Getting my opponent some good advantages here. So now I have six mana, so let's play the Puzzle Knot first. See what we scry into here. Bottom, put Gifted Aether Board on top. I'm going to Daring Demolition the Scrapper and hit with the Swooper and make a token, I think. I'll go to six here. So I have four energy, so I could have not Daring Demolition and used Whirler Maker instead. But then I'd be losing a servo, and I would kind of run the risk of my opponent having... I guess they would have to have two removal spells because I could use Whirler Maker, but I think I'm happy with this. And then next turn I can play Gifted Aetherborn. Another reason to Daring Demolition, by the way, is Gifted Aetherborn wants to be able to attack, and the Scrapper Champion would stop it. Okay, so Welder Automaton is good. That was the card my opponent drew last turn, I think, because they scryed it to the top, and then they scryed something to the bottom and drew a land. I don't think they should have attacked with the Watchful Automaton. I think that was actually a mistake, because now they could just be scrying. I mean, they're pink. I guess part of the reason they did is they have Welder Automaton, so they want to spend their mana on that instead, but I don't know. I feel like that Watchful Automaton trading for two servos and six damage wasn't great for them. All right, Whirler Maker's making some whirls here. Let's send with these two, three. Actually, send with everything. Yeah, because I'm going to Glassblower's Puzzle Knot here to get some energy. Sure. Yeah, these cards are all fine. And make a servo. I assume my opponent's going to do some blocks. All right, then they take some damage, and I gain some lives. And then I get to play an island, and I still have Whirler Maker up. And my opponent pinging me with this Welder Automaton is just not going to get the job done here. Also, I'm drawing Make Obsolete next turn. Four value. All right. So I want to put in Perilous Predicament. Artifact creature and non-artifact creature. They have a bunch of tokens, but they have just a couple non-artifact creatures. I kind of like that. Make Obsolete is going to be very good in this matchup. I kind of don't want Augmenting Automaton as much because of the red Puzzle Knot. I mean, they can kill the Poisoner, but the Poisoner at least will get some value, whereas this will just hang out and play, being targeted for so long. And I think I'll try the Perilous Predicament over that. All right, let's see what my opponent is up to here. all right, I'm going to keep this. My opponent's mulling to six. I think I actually would rather have Perilous Predicament in my hand here than Augmenting Automaton. I can just... I need to draw a card that's cheap, like an Aether Swooper or something, but just going during Demolition into Perilous Predicament against an opponent who mulligans seems kind of nice, especially since the improvised decks sometimes run a little low on actual threats. So I think there is a chance that this is decent. Oh, what do you know? Aether Swooper. Also, that swamp could have been an island, and it did not matter. Prism, sure. Oh, I do a 2-drop and a 3-drop after keeping a 5-land hand with powerful 4 and 5 drops. It's pretty standard, honestly. Sky Skiff. Let's just play the Automaton. Attack, make myself a token. Ba-boom. Alright, what you got here? Weldfast Monitor. Mobile Garrison coming in. Attacking, untapping the Weldfast Monitor. The question is, do I want a Daring Demolition the Weldfast Monitor? Yeah, I think so. Because I have Perilous Predicament in my hand, I don't mind killing one of their creatures, and then just this lets me attack. I guess if they play a non-artifact creature now, then I would have rather not use Daring Demolition. Oh, this looks like a Bastion Inventor. Oh, Maverick Thopterist. No, Bastion Inventor. Oh, a Free Jam Regent. Okay, that's large. All right, let's just play a Swooper and a Sky Skiff and hope my opponent does not play a non-artifact creature. But I think it's way more likely they just play an artifact creature given the makeup of their deck here. I guess I'm running a bit of a risk, but the only non-artifact creatures we've really seen out of their deck is like Scrapper Champion and Free Jam Regent so far. Just not very many. Yeah. Got greedy and got rewarded, I suppose. Well, I guess my opponent could play a cheap creature here, but... Ooh, they get to attack with the Free Jam Regent too? Oh, they did not. Okay. Well, I'm going to take... no, I'm going to block here. I'll trade one of these creatures for a Mobile Garrison. Why not? I mean, if they have like a Precise Strike or something, I get kind of owned here, but what can you do? Trade for an Aether Swooper, apparently. Perilous Predicament's about to be good. Yeah, it's still going to be good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I get to send in with Aether Swooper. Actually, I'm going to send in with... animate the Sky Skiff. Yeah, I'll trade Watchful Automatons here. I'll offer that deal since I've got a lot of action already and I'm happy enough trading. Let's see what my opponent's got here. Blue Implement. All right, well, that's not going to get you out of this situation. I'm up a decent amount here. And there we go. Hooray!